Hello, I'm gonna show you how to make a farm using wheat seeds. So first, what you will need is a water bucket. I have already done this, but basically you get water and fill up one pieces of holes. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Go 5 blocks between each hole or something. I don't know, it's up to you. And then, what is important is that one tile of water can water many tiles around it. So 4 tiles of water can water like 80 tiles or something. Once you have put water in some sort of nice area like me, you need a hoe. You can have iron hoe or wooden hoe. And then you need to right click the ground to till the soil to make it ready for the seeds to grow in it. So you do like this until you till every piece of soil around the water blocks. If you go 2 blocks away, you can be sure it works. See? Water over here will water this block. So if you do, only 4 water tiles can water so much tilings. Also, I was gonna do one thing first. I hate when I get the crops, they go in the water sometimes. So what I like to do is put a wooden slab or any kind of slab above it. This will make sure the crops do not go in the water when you're harvesting it. So here I do dee-dee-dee. But because I did this, I have to fix some ground here. I broke some of the soil. So now you don't have to worry about crops going in the water. And you have tilled the soil. Now what you need next is a lot of woody seed. This wood seed, you need to put them by right clicking on the ground. Right click on the soil that you have tilled using a hoe. And until you have put it in every single tile to maximize the amount of farming feeling you can do in your garden. Oh, do I have enough woody seed to complete this? I don't think so. Oopsie, I thought I had enough. Lols, I need 3, 4 more, 5. Oh no, make sure you have enough woody seeds to complete the farm. If you need more woody seed, you're gonna have to punch grass. I guess I can't finish, put it in every tile, because I cannot, I miscalculated. Now what is important for this farm is that you don't jump on it. I'll show you what happens if you jump too much. Oh no, see, it's a broken tile here. Oh no, it's a broken tile, broken. You do not want to jump on the farm, because a broken tile, you have to do the hole again. So when you're in the farm, you can walk around and you can run, but you, or can you run? Let's see, can I run? Yes, I can. You can run and walk, but do not jump because that breaks the tiles. You have to no jumpy when you're farming. Now what you need is maybe some defense because you don't want a creeper to be in the farm or something. Creeper exploding in the farm will be very sad. So to defend the farm, I recommend building some defense. And you may wonder, what kind of defense can I build? I'm gonna show you. You can use this defense here. What did I do? 30 buttons. What is this crap? Oopsie, I didn't mean to make 30 buttons. But now I can have many buttons. Many. These buttons don't do anything. I just made too many for no reason. So I'm using them to decorate. It's like a pony. Oh no, one is on the floor. You can put on the floor. What I meant to do was these here. No. What I meant to do was How do you make a fence in this crap? You need to make ogifoons. That's what I wanted to do. Ogifoons and stooks. Stooks and ogifoons. Now the good thing about the foons fence is that you can't jump over it. So the creepers and monsters cannot jump over one piece of fence. The fence is very good because it's a one block. There is enough to block every monster except Spooties. Maybe some other ones. So now I have, now you see, I have the Fonzie around my farm to prevent the monster from exploding my Krubby. Now, I want to add another thing. You want to have some light in the farm, because if you don't have light, the monsters will spawn inside the fence, and then all hell will break loose because the monsters are spawning in the farm. And then you can finish the fence. And it should be very safe, no monster. I don't have enough fence to finish these. So I'm gonna go get more fence materials than these in my house. I think I still have some here. Oh, I only have sprucey lug. I only have the sprucey lug. I think that will make a different kind of fence. Am I correct? Will I get a different kind of fence? Let's find out. Sprucey foons. Yes, you get a sprucey foons with a sprucey oog. Sprucey loog. Oog. So, you want to finish the fence. These will not be the same color. It is okay with this variety. Multi-fence color. We have a little darker color here, it's okay. You may want to put some torch outside the fence too, just to reduce the chance of monsters being near the farm, because it's a friendly farm, happy place feeling. Now you may wonder, how do you get inside the farm? Now I can't jump over the fence and not the monster. But what you should do is make a super special item. In fact, I will do diddle doodle, beedle beedle, boo boo. I'm gonna do a little diddle do, and I'm gonna show you what you can do. What you can do is, I don't know. What can I do? I don't know. You need to do something like, I think, I'm not sure. How do I do this? Maybe it was like a D's here. Oh, there we go. Sprucey, Funso, Goaty. You need to make some Funso Goaty. Sprucey Funsy Goaty. And now you can open a door. Open a door. You can also put a pressure plate to make sure the gate closes when you enter it. Closings. So now you can be in the farm and don't have to worry about the monster attacking you while you are farming. Now you can see our crops are starting to grow. There is lots of torches here, so no monsters are spawning here. And that's how you make a woody, sooty farm. If you want to do it my style, then you can have some fun by jumping. Oh no, I broke one. Can I jump across? You can jump across like, if you fail, you break the crops. Ha, what a fun game, 10 out of 10. But breaking the crops is very sad. Go cry every time you... Wait, I don't know.